Today I'll be taking you through another interesting journey where we had a visit from an 85-year-old lady, basically an octogenarian, who was living alone in her house in Salem and was suffering from pain in the knee on the left side for more than 3 to 4 months of duration. She was referred to us by another senior orthopedic surgeon with relevant scans done. And what was a bit of issue was that she was not able to put too much of weight and walk and carry out her daily activities. When we had a look at the imaging, that's one of the x-rays in the MRI, what we found that we saw that there was a big area of the bone along the weight-bearing part in the around the knee, which was basically eaten up. The first thing we suspect in an 85-year-old is something called as bone metastasis, that is a spread of the cancer from any other part of the body to the bone. And one of the second points we do see is that, is it a manifestation of a blood cancer?
My name is Raja Panga. I'm in the hospital for 3 months. I'm in the hospital for 4 months. I'm in the hospital for 4 months. I'm in the hospital for 4 months. பையன் அப்பாயின்மெண்ட் வாங்கி அவரை போய் பார்த்தேன். அவரு இல்லைம்மா நான் உங்களை நல்லா நடத்த வைக்கிறேன்னு சொல்லி கான்ஃபிடென்ட்டாக ஆப்ரேஷன் செய்ய ஒத்துக்கிட்டாரு.
So we try to do our test. And immediately I performed a core needle biopsy, basically with a small needle, and we went through this area and we just took a small chunk of tissue. And to our surprise, the report came out as something called a giant cell tumor. So what is interesting here is this giant cell tumor, we do usually see it between 20 years to 40 years of age, and there have been very rare incidences documented in elderly age population. To our knowledge, 85 year old with a giant cell tumor is one of the oldest in the world, to the literature review which me and my team could go through. So again, we tried to go back, make sure we're dealing with a very benign aggressive bone tumor, that is a non-cancerous tumor. And we try to relook through the tests, we try to relook through the biopsy again so that we don't miss anything. We even try to check the thyroid, trying to find out that there's no issue with the thyroid or the parathyroid. So once this was done, we actually sat down with the lady and the family, and we told them that this is the scenario, this is a benign bone tumor, and that we need to operate on her so that we can rid of the disease. The two options which we discussed with them was one where we try to go into the tumor and try to clear up and put a cement and a fixation like this, where we save the knee joint. Surprisingly, her knee was not arthritic even at 85 years of age. That means her active lifestyle had helped her save her knee quite longer than our other age-related population results which we see. And the other option would have been to actually remove this whole bone and put in a tumor megaprosthesis. Her motivation gave us more impetus to try and go in and clear out the disease. And we did clear it out, put a cement and a platum, as you can see in the postoperative x-ray here. She's back to her normal self, walking around, basically going for grocery shopping, going to the bank, taking care of her own need, and she still lives alone. So this surgery again was possible by the help of our anesthesia team, our cardiology team, and basically our geriatric specialist, who made sure that even with a minor comorbid conditions, she had an absolutely comfortable perioperative and postoperative stay, and basically she was just discharged on the third postoperative day and she was back home taking care of herself.
இந்த ஏஜில் ஆப்ரேஷன் பண்ண எல்லாரும் தயங்கினாங்க. அவரு தான் எனக்கு ரிஸ்க் எடுத்து பண்ணி என்னை நடக்க வச்சிருக்காரு. தேங்க்ஸ் ஃபுல்லா டாக்டர் சீமன் இருக்கிறாங்க.
I would like to emphasize that coming early again gives the best of the results, and we don't have to do aggressive surgeries to treat the situation of the patient also. Thank you so much.